Hey everyone, a very good day to all of you. Myself Neha Gupta, and today I have brought to you the RBI phase 2 cutoff analysis. So I hope that all of you are preparing really hard for the examination, but preparing hard and preparing strategically, these two are two different things. So if you want to prepare strategically, first of all guys, we have given you a crash course for that. Secondly guys, you need to prepare a personalized strategy for you all. Now how are you going to prepare a personalized strategy? By analyzing the cutoff of previous year. This is something that I am going to unveil in this video. So be there till the end of this video to know what was the cutoff in the previous year, what is the expected level of questions in the coming examination, at the same time what could be the expected cutoff. So let's move ahead. But this is the application that you can download to know what are the offerings from our side. Here you will get the daily GK quizzes, exam updates, topper strategy, everything is there. Past year papers are also there. So go through the application, download it from the Play Store. This is guys our crash course for phase 2, and this has been specifically curated to prepare the students in 20 to 25 days for the phase 2. Okay, so if you really want to know what are the offerings or what are the topics that we are going to discuss in the crash course, you can visit our website courses.anujindal.in or anujindal.in, okay, to know about this crash course better. Now guys, this is something that holds utmost importance for all of you at this moment, because this is the way through which you can connect with us. So this is the phone number, Monday to Saturday, 9 a.m. to 6 p.m. You can call us at any moment if you need guidance. Again, we have one more channel, the emails. If you don't get so much time to talk to us, then you can also mail us. We are going to resolve your queries. Plus, we have the discussion forums and the Telegram channel. So we are here for you all. Don't feel alone at this moment in your journey. We are here to guide you. You can connect with us anytime. Okay. But to remember, 9 to 6 p.m. on this number, Monday to Saturday. And also remember that 6 to 8 p.m. is the time period where Anuj sir takes calls from the students. So if you directly want to talk to him, then you can call between 6 p.m. to 8 p.m. in the evening, okay, on the same number. So that was all. Now let's move on to the cutoff analysis. Now this is something that is theoretical in nature and is of no use for all of us at this moment. Therefore, I'm going to skip it, okay. I just put it here so that you all know the process of creating the cutoffs. So guys, this is 2017, the year in which the examination was really tough. The level was really high. So let's have a look at the cutoff of phase 2, particularly written examination. I'm also not going to look at the final cutoff list, which also includes your interview marks, because at this moment, phase 2 should be our focus, okay, the written examination. So here we have 196.75. cutoff for general, 175 for the SCSTs and 181 for the OBCs. Also remember, the level of examination was a bit higher, or I should say difficult, in this year. But the cutoff has also gone higher. Then comes 2018. The level of examination was really, really, I would say, easy to moderate, and the cutoff went higher. So here you can clearly draw a relationship between the level of examination and the cutoff. If the level of examination is low, cutoff can go up. And if the level of examination is high, then cutoff may go down. Okay, so this is one relationship. Then comes 2019. Again, the level of examination was easy to moderate. So here we are seeing the cutoff of 193.25, then 172. For SCSTs, then we have OBCs, 188 cutoff. Okay, for EWS category, we have the same cutoff as of general category. So here, general category and EWS are going to have the same cutoff. Okay, so this is something that is there in the notification itself, that no other kind of benefit would be given to the EWS as far as the qualification criteria is concerned, as far as the age limit is concerned, and other qualification requirements or the cutoff for that matter is concerned. Okay, so this is guys 2019 year. Then we have 2020 to 2021 year, and this is guys the basis on which we are going to draw our comparison, our analysis, because this is the year when we have descriptive plus objective papers both in the phase 2. Prior to this, since 2017 to 2019 we did not have the amalgamation of descriptive plus objective, therefore we cannot clearly say what could be the level. But since we have this year already to compare, so we are going to look at the level of the questions and the level of the cutoff. So in 2020 to 2021, here two things are to be considered. First, since this is the year in which the new pattern was introduced, therefore the level of questions was easy to moderate. Okay, so here we can see that the cutoff is somewhere 187.75%, which is not at all very low because the level of examination is lower and we have a cutoff of 187.75 for the general category, 187.75 for OBCs, and for EWS 167.75 or 166 is for SC and ST. Okay, level is down, but the cutoff is somewhere also down in comparison to the previous years, right? In 2019, you have approximately 190 ke aaspaas ki cutoff, but here you have 187.75 cutoff. So cutoff has also gone down with the level of examination. But why has this happened? Because the pattern was new for the students. But give me an answer. Is this pattern new for all of you now? No. So RBI also knows this fact, guys, that this pattern is no more new to the candidates who are appearing. Plus, they are well prepared for the examination. Therefore, RBI is expected to raise the level of questions in your phase 2. So prepare accordingly. Secondly, you all are prepared. You all know that you are going to face objective plus descriptive. You have a limited time period, this and so on. So you all are prepared. Therefore, your performance is likely to go up. So both of these factors are indicating that the level of questions are going to go up in this year's examination, plus your cutoff might go up because students are also well prepared and there is a limited number of seats for which RBI needs candidates, right? Secondly, in your last year's examination, phase one examination was really, really difficult, right? All of you agree with me? So phase one was difficult and RBI had the opportunity to eliminate the maximum number of candidates in the phase one itself. But here, what did we see in phase one of 2022? The level was a bit easy to moderate, not very difficult like you had in your 2020 to 2021 examination. Therefore, many students are likely to clear the phase one. Therefore, they are going to appear in the phase two and RBI has again a limited number of seats. Therefore, RBI is going to make the question paper tough, a bit tough, and ho sakta hai cutoff bhi badha de kyunki limited number of seats hai. Only 238 seats are there and how many people can RBI take or qualify for the interviews? This is something that you all need to understand. Therefore, here we have got 2 to 3 reasons for which RBI can increase the level of paper this year and at the same time cutoff can also increase in this year. Plus, guys, you also need to understand that, for example, in SEBI also this happened, that when SEBI changed its syllabus, it made the paper easier, but a year after, in this year, the paper was difficult because all the students are acquainted with the fact that the syllabus has changed and they have prepared accordingly. Okay, so this is one fact that you all need to understand. Okay, so prepare really hard for the examination. Now, the second thing that you all need to understand is that this is, guys, this written paper is the turning point in your RBI's journey. Okay, because this is somewhere you can score maximum marks. In interviews, it does not matter how good you are doing. It all depends upon the interviewer. How much marks does the interviewer is willing to give to you? That is something that holds importance in this stage. So here, you have the opportunity to score the maximum and clear the examination because this is in your hand. Your preparation, your attempt, your scores, everything is in your hand here. So prepare accordingly. Now, what could be the expected cutoff this year? So guys, you faced 187.75 cutoff last year when the examination pattern was also new. RBI kept the level of examination low. But here, as I told you, the performances of students would be good expectedly. And secondly, RBI is also well prepared. Okay, so here you can expect the cutoff to go up, but what should be your target score? So in my opinion, if you keep the general EWS people and the OBCs, because you can see that your cutoffs are similar, so you need to keep the score somewhere around 200. If you are able to score this much, then you are on a safer side. Now, how can you create your personalized strategy from this score? This is something I'm going to talk about here. So guys, here is your pattern of phase 2 examination, ESI, finance and management and English. So there would be some candidate whose ESI is really good. There would be a person whose FM is good, or there would be a person whose writing skills is good, writing skills are good and is well versed in English. Okay, so choose the subject, whichever it is, whichever is your strength, then focus on your strength. Okay, try to score maximum marks into it. Divide the 200 marks, okay, into three subjects and try to score the maximum in the subject that is your strength. But at the same time, don't ignore the other subjects, right? Because these are also going to help you go through the examination, okay? So this should be your personalized strategy. Now, if you are good at ESI, so scoring approximately 70 marks in ESI out of 100, I know it's a really, it's a hard nut to crack, but still, 70 score agar aap kar rahe hain ESI mein, then I guess it would put you on a safer side if your ESI is strong. If your FM is strong, 70 marks, if you are scoring here, then obviously you are going to go on a safer side. And if your English is strong, then again, if you score 70 in English and in your ESI and FM you have a little bit low score, then also you are on a safer side. So this could be your strategy for the examination. Okay, so identify your strength. For the SC/ST candidates, guys, this time your number of vacancies have reduced, therefore you can expect your cutoff to also go up. So what could be your safe score? So guys, in my opinion, if you keep a target of scoring 180 marks, then definitely you would be on a safer side. So divide this 180 into 3, 60 60 60, okay, and then identify which one of these three subjects is your strength. For example, if ESI is your strength of a person belonging to the SC/ST category, then if you are scoring 70 marks into it, then obviously you are going to get a leverage here, right? Because the minimum should be 60 60 60 if you want to sail through this examination. So if you are scoring 70 here, then you have the leverage to score a bit low in other two examinations. But at the same time, I am again saying, don't put a lesser weightage to any of the other subjects which are not your strong subjects, okay? Because strong nahi hai, to aapko uspe zyada mehnat karni hai. Agar koi subject aapki strength hai, to obviously uspe aapko mehnat karne ki thodi si kam zarurat hai. But agar usko aap strategically prepare karenge aur usme agar aap achha score la pa rahi hai, that means you are clearing the examination this year. So guys, that was the analysis. That should be your personalized strategy. And here I'm going to say goodbye to all of you. If you have any query, anything else to discuss with me, you are free to comment below. You are free to call us. You are free to do mails, or you can also connect with us on the Telegram channel. Thank you so much guys for watching this video. Have a good day. Prepare really hard.